Hi everybody, this is me. My name's Brianna. I thought I would give everyone some tips on, well, some things I've learned about how to train dogs. So I know they are impossible to train. So, hold on, let me readjust this so you can see me not looking way off to the side. That's a little better. Okay, so I have here with me some helpers. Let's see, there she is. That's Marley. And let's see if we can get Sam in the shot. There's Sam. Biddy! And this little one who Marley is blocking right now. Biddy! Watch out, Marley. Biddy, come. It's hard to get them to come to the screen because they're afraid of it, but I'll get it. Here's Biddy. They're three of my dogs, and okay, so Marley here, she is the one who. She can sometimes be kind of aggressive, so I thought let's start with that because you know, a lot of you are probably looking for help with that, so I won't make you wait. What we did with her is, well, we haven't really solved her problems sometimes being aggressive to other dogs, but she would sometimes not be nice to people she didn't trust yet. And so what we did is we found out that if they just let her come to them instead of them trying to go up to her, and she would you know, learn to love them, and she would never really hurt anybody, but she has sometimes like just like bit somebody, but not hard, just, you know, enough to get them to stop trying to touch her or whatever. And so yeah, and she has sometimes gotten into fights with our other dogs, but the way we learned to resolve that is that if she fights with the other dogs, then whatever it is they're fighting over, she does not get to have that for just temporarily. And then she learns that she doesn't get to have things if she's mean. And she's really a sweet girl, though. Look at this face. Look at this face. How can this not be a sweet dog? She just doesn't trust, like, anybody almost, except, well, my mom, my brother, me, her previous owners, and our dogs, and also some of our close family members. Okay, so, Sam, where are you, Sam? Sam, you don't want to just show your tail, that's weird. Yeah, he's walking by. He's a little bit, like, he's an active dog, so it's a little hard to catch him. He is the one with, like, crazy anxiety issues that he's always had. And so, what we usually do about that is when he's having his anxiety issues, we just, you know, try to pet him, calm him down. And we used to have one of those thunder shirts, but I don't know what happened to it. And it sometimes worked, but not always, so we kind of stopped using it, I guess, because we just, you know, it was great because it sometimes worked, but we just really didn't like sort of not knowing when it wasn't gonna work. So yeah, and sometimes we distract him from whatever it is he's having anxiety about, and it kind of works because he starts to see that it doesn't have to take up his whole mind. So, And then Biddy, she's off doing something right now, so I won't make her come. She, like, when the other dogs misbehave and we tell them no, she gets upset with the other dogs and she'll bark at them, sometimes even bite at them. And so the way that we're, you know, learning to deal with that is we have to put Biddy on her back and tell her no. And she, I know some people, you know, sort of disagree with that, but it's just that, you know, she really doesn't like it, but we have to sort of keep the other dogs from getting hurt. And so, and she has to somehow learn that, you know, if she bites the other dogs, it's going to have consequences she doesn't like. So, yeah, and she's doing better with that. They're all doing better with their behaviors. And as far as training them, as far as, you know, tricks, like sitting, lying down, all of that, I have learned that so many dogs, like, their breeds, like, no matter how hard they might try to learn, some breeds it just takes them longer. And of course, it doesn't apply to every dog in the breed, but it's just applies to a lot of the dogs in the breed. Like her. There she is. She's pretty easy to train because, honestly, she's an attention hog. So it's pretty easy to train her because she, you know, as long as you pet her or give her a treat or something, it'll kind of stick in her mind forever. And this one here, she is a little bit harder to train because she's like, well, the problem, well, I mean, it's generally a good thing, but with training her, it can be kind of tough sometimes. She is always a happy little dog. And so, like, if you give her treats or pet her or something for doing something good, then she's happy, but it's kind of like, I guess she's like, well, I'm just going to be happy anyway, so I guess it's not really as big of a deal if I get treats or something. And then Sam over here, he gets a little bit harder to train because he has so much anxiety. Oh, Biddy jumped on my lap. You'll probably see that in a lot of my future videos. She jumps. Here she is. And yes, I am wearing an Elvis shirt, for those of you who are wondering. So, but know that not all pit bulls are going to be attention hogs, and not all chihuahuas are going to be happy all the time, and not all beagles are going to be anxiety filled. In fact, I'm not sure I've ever met another beagle or beagle mix who was anxiety filled like he is. Yeah. And, okay, so what we usually do to sort of get work through that for training them is, well, for Marley, with her being an attention hog, like I said, it's kind of easy, but it can get in the way sometimes because sometimes she just wants your attention so badly that she misbehaves, like jumping on top of you or, you know, pushing the other dogs out of the way. And so the way that we do that is we tell her no. If she does that, then she gets the negative attention. And so she kind of learns that she doesn't want to do that because she is an attention hog, but she knows that she doesn't want negative attention. And as for Biddy, where she's like always happy, you kind of have to work with them more than most other dogs, make them realize that, yeah, it's, you know, if they're always happy, then they might not care about treats as much and stuff like that, but make them realize that, hey, why not go for being even happier? And then with him, with his anxiety, what we've found is you have to find Well, like I had said earlier, you have to calm him down, and you also have to find ways to introduce him to stuff so that he just gets used to it, but find ways that are not anxiety provoking. Maybe if you think he's going to have anxiety about something and you're going to introduce him to it, maybe give him treats and things like that while you're introducing him to it. And as far as stuff that sort of applies to all dogs, just how to get them to know what you're talking about, maybe I can demonstrate that one. That'd be a little easier. Just hold on, hold tight for like 30 seconds. Promise I'll be right back as soon as I get the supplies. Hello again. Okay, here I have the two end pieces of bread from the loaf that was in my pantry. Okay, I found, obviously, a lot of dog owners have found pretty much every single one, that treats, although it can make your dog pay attention to you, it can sort of make them become distracted from what you're saying or trying to do. And so, I've found that, any misbehavior that they are doing while you have treats, you have to tell them, no, don't continue to give them the treat until they start behaving better. And that way, they realize that they might miss out on treats sometimes if they act badly. And, and another thing, just, I should mention this before I go on with giving them the treats, some dogs, after you tell them no, for instance, her, they'll start to, get worried that you're really, mad at them, or you are going to hit them or something, which of course we never do in our family. But Marley here, she was abused, way before her previous owner got her. Her very first owner was mean to her. And so she does get worried about that sometimes when we tell her no. But I've found that the way to take care of that and still let them know that you're serious, that they can't do that stuff, is, if they're just seeming a little bit like they're just trying to get away with it, then you just continue to tell them no. But if they seem, genuinely scared, then just, a minute later, pet them, reassure them, you still love them, you're not gonna hurt them. And that's kind of how you do it. And so, okay, and try to focus it in on them. Just give me a second here. Okay, I'll do one at a time so you can see them clearly. Okay, Marley, lie down. Nope, lie down. Okay, she did it. Lie down, stay. Nope, lie down. Okay, good dog. Sam, lie down. Sam, lie down. Lie down. Lie down, Sam. Lie down. Good dog, you did it. Biddy, sit. Biddy doesn't know lie down yet. Sit. Good dog. Okay, now we'll try some different tricks. Let me move this here. Okay, now you can see it. Marley, pop. Good dog. Give me your paw, but just one paw. Just one. Same paw. Same paw. Same paws. Good dog. Biddy paw. Biddy paw. She doesn't know that either, but, you know, I'm still trying to train her in it, so. Biddy paw. Biddy paw. Okay, good. Paw. No, paw. Paw. Biddy. Biddy, give me your paw. Biddy, come on. Give me the paw. Good dog. That's paw. She doesn't know it, but she just sort of did it coincidentally. Okay, the next one you're going to see Marley do is that she knows she has to wait for the treat. If you tell her wait, then she will usually do it. Marley, wait. Wait, 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 wait. Good girl. See, the ultimate test of that trick is if you can touch them with the treat and they still don't go for it. Marley, back there. Marley, move. Okay, now we can see Sam do the trick. Marley, scoot out of the way. Scooch. No, no, no. Let them see Sam. Okay, Sam. Nope, wait. Wait. He knows. Nah, wait. Sam. Wait. Okay. Now, Biddy. My brother might have taught Biddy this one. I'm not sure, so let's see. Biddy, wait. Wait. Ah, wait. Ah, wait. Okay. Yeah, it seems like she's had a little bit of training in that before. Okay. And I found, you know, another good thing for dogs. Maybe sometimes just let them have treats without them having to do tricks. Just let it be fun time for them, which I think it actually helps the training because they realize that you're not always going to be telling them to do stuff. So they don't always have to be stressed about that. There you go, Marley. Hey, Sam. They usually don't do that, but sometimes. Marley, go. Ah, Sam! Marley. You get two because Sam took yours. Biddy. Biddy. Sam, no. Biddy. And I usually say their names when I give them the treats because they know they can't take each other's food, and if you say their name, then they know who it's supposed to go to. Okay, now you can have a turn, Sam. They're going a little bit crazy right now. I don't know why. They usually are a little better behaved than this. Marley. Biddy. Sam. Marley. Biddy. Sam. Marley. Biddy. Sam. Marley. Biddy. Sam. I always think it's funny when they try to grab it and it bounces off their teeth. Okay. Another thing, as far as their walks, well, I'll admit, none of these three are very well-trained in walks yet, but we did get our first dog, Hogan, and our greyhounds, who, our greyhounds live with my mom's ex-husband now, and anyway, we got the three of them to do pretty well on walks, and we did it by, we would stop whenever they would pull, we would stop and just, you know, be like, well, we're not going on if you're going to be pulling. And so, and it took a while, but it eventually worked. And so, yeah, that's most of the advice I have on walks. I guess I can also say that you don't want to have the leash too long or too short, because too long, it just makes them think that they can, you know, walk in front of you, be like dominant, all that. And too short, it doesn't give them any room to do what it is they want to do. So they don't end up learning that they have to listen to you. Do you know what I mean? It's like if they go up into, if the leash is really long, they go up into a neighbor's yard, and you tell them no. Well, if you do that enough times, they'll learn they have to stay close to you. But if the leash is too short, then they'll never get the opportunity to learn it. So I'd say you want to keep it medium length. Also because if it's too long, it's not safe for them. They could run into the street or something like that. And if it's too short, it's not safe for them because it's really easy to accidentally pull too hard and it hurts them. So, yep. And just give me a second. I'm gonna put some stuff on the screen for you. And this may come up backwards because I'm not that experienced with webcams yet. So, I hope it's coming up the right way. Just letting you guys know, I also have a few different kinds of videos. One of them is it's a song I'm working on for auditions, because I do act, and I have another one I'm working on for auditions, and one is, well, it's a mistake that I sent in about, it was on Conan O'Brien's show. They made a mistake, and they have this thing where you can send in mistakes and then they try to prove you wrong, and it's pretty funny. But I didn't actually get to send it in yet, because when I made it, I was 17, and you have to be 18 to do it. And so now that I'm 18, I'm gonna check and see if they've still got that and you can still do that, and hopefully they will still have that. Okay, just in case it does come up backwards, this, hold on, right up here, hold on, top here, says rate, comment, and subscribe, this yellow here says spend time with your pets today, this green is obviously a smiley face, that purple says bye.